Sound check. Sound check. There we go. Okay. I think we're good now. How's the sound for everybody? Too loud? Can you hear the music? Okay, so the reason why the music skips in and out sometimes is because I'm like juggling between the game window and OBS. Whenever I go fiddle with something in OBS, the music cuts out for like a second. Should hear the game music like about now, right? You're not hearing any music at all? Okay, cool. My bad. The stream should be at 720p. So, let's see here. Okay, yeah. Right, so I'm done playing around with the OBS settings. I'm pretty sure everything's set. Let's wait a couple more minutes, see if any stragglers are gonna show up. And we'll talk about what we're doing. How's everybody doing? Are there still any audio or technical issues you are all facing? Okay. All right. All right. This is gonna be weird. I'm eating pineapple. This is gonna be weird. This is gonna be all live. It's not attractive. Okay, face cam's on. You've seen it. I'll be right back when we finish this. Neko got the face cams for you. You know what's you know, when I'm recording by myself, like, it's all cool. I could just like act however I want. And then I started using face cam, and then things got really embarrassing. And now face cam's gonna be live. This can even be more embarrassing. Oh, Jesus. Whatever, it's 210. That's good enough. Let's talk real quick about what the goal of this is. Obviously, episode 5 has not come out yet. I'm not going to be streaming episode 5 until I play it through myself first. What I was thinking we could do is start a second game and just dick around. Like, we can make Max into a total bitch. We can just, like, have everybody hate her. We can just screw everybody over, and that way, when I'm done playing episode 5 on my normal game, we can go back and see how things would have been different if, you know, we played Max differently. I think that might be fun, but honestly, like, I'm pretty tired right now. I stayed up all night. I intended to record Soma around 11 p.m. last night. For a frame of reference, it's currently like 2:11 p.m. on the West Coast right now. But around 11 p.m. last night, I wanted to record Soma, but my neighbors were having a party, and they went from like 10 p.m. all the way until like 11 a.m. So I stayed up the whole night. I couldn't sleep, couldn't record. So I'm not sure how long this stream is gonna last. But whatever, we'll keep going. We'll go as long as I can, like, stay awake. Is that a spammer in chat? Cool, we finally got a spammer in chat. I don't even know what this link does. Nah, don't click it. Yeah. Interesting. Yeah, the chat screen is pretty delayed. I'm not sure. Yeah, the delay on the chat screen is because of delay on OBS. How it's working is I've set up OBS to directly pull the chat direct from Twitch. So it's pulling the information the moment you type it, putting it through OBS. That's why you see it on the screen itself. Yeah, and whenever I do anything in the game, OBS is gonna lag by, like, I think it's like 650 milliseconds. Actually, no, it's like 15 seconds, actually. Yeah. So I can't really do anything to help that. I haven't figured it out yet, so that's... Can't really... do much about it. I'm using this whole chat thing inside the picture because it's easier for me to just export straight to YouTube right away instead of having to like superimpose the chat box into the file like I did with Until Dawn. Forgot what I was talking about already. Anyway, I'm really tired. We'll go for a while, for as long as I can, but the point of the point of this stream is just to hang out, chill, play the game. If you guys want to talk about anything, we can talk about it while we're going through like the game all over again. It's whatever you want. I'm just like, just want to hang out and like get hyped for the release tomorrow. basically, if you guys want to talk about theories, we can totally talk about theories. I could probably talk about a bunch. Let me show you. Let me show you. I don't know. It's just my luck to have this happen. After I finished playing episode 4, and while I was editing, I basically scribbled every single piece of note paper that I could when I had an idea for a video, for a theory video, and I just couldn't get around to it. Stuff came up, plus I was procrastinating for a while too, so unfortunately, like, most of those aren't gonna happen. I'll be lucky if I can get like one or two important videos out. I don't know. So I can just talk about a lot of the ideas that I had. That way, like, it's out there before episode 5 comes out. Yeah. Yeah, it's a lot. Like, it's a bunch. Like, it's just note papers on note papers. I should have written them in a folder, but I just wrote them on, like, old pieces of mail. This is weird. Like, I found out about this game before it came out. I played it on day one. So having it end is very strange. Life is strange. Okay. I think I've wasted enough time. Let's get going. Yeah, it's a lot of work for one game, but I think this game is really special. Like, I thought it was just gonna be a simple, like, little fun high school drama, and then look what happened. Like, I've never put so much effort into, like, presenting any kind of, like, for fun medium before. It's just a game. What a game. It's okay. This game will end. Something will replace it. Like,
where am I? What's happening? I'm trapped in a storm? How did I get here? And where is here? There's the lighthouse. I'll be safe if I can make it there. I hope. Please let me make it there.
Yeah, after full boyfriend will come. So basically, the reason why I'm very confident that there will be another game that'll come along and replace all the hype and the community that this one built is because it set a new standard for, like, choose your own adventure storytelling. It did a good thing. So there'll be more games like this. Maybe not as good right away. A couple. Still need to find out what exactly happened in that little hut and in that lighthouse.
So surreal.
Famously called film Little Pieces of Time. But he could be talking about photography, as he likely was.
Okay. I'm in class. Everything's cool. I'm okay.
From light to shadow. From color to chiaroscuro. Now, can you give me an example of a photographer who perfectly captured the human condition in black and white?
I didn't fall asleep, and that sure didn't feel like a dream.
Bueller.
Weird.
Diane Arbus.
There you go, Victoria. Why Arbus?
Look at this crap. How can I show this to Mr. Jefferson? I can hear the class laughing at me now.
Alright, so you see this photo wall, right? It's pretty complete. In the episode, like, in the menu where you can pick the episodes that you want to play, one of the episodes had this exact, photo, except her wall wasn't as full. This is one of the pieces of evidence that makes me really wonder if the timelines in this game are not just like crisscross and blending constantly, because that's the only explanation that I could come up with. Other than like the only other explanation I can come up with is Don't Nod did a lot of like hard things that are just meant to fuck with us, you know? It's hard to tell. Plus the whole Hitchcock thing with little pieces of time, a lot of early on thematic stuff, which will be important later. I'll talk about that
because
later.
Of her images of hopeless faces, you feel like totally haunted by the eyes of those sad mothers and children.
She saw humanity as tortured, right? And frankly, it's bullshit. Keep that to yourself. Seriously though, I could frame any one of you in a dark corner and capture you in a moment of desperation. And any one of you could do that to me. Isn't that too easy? Too obvious? What if Arbus chose to capture people at the height of their beauty or innocence? She had a brilliant eye, so she could have taken another approach.
I have to admit, I'm not a big fan of
I should take a picture to prove I'm still here. Plus, it's perfect for my portfolio.
Me too.
And I have to get my daily selfie,
Clara. He captured the essence of post-war beat America. And there was honesty about the economic conditions of the era. But a beauty in the struggle. You don't have beauty with a shh. I believe Max has taken what you kids call a selfie. A dumb word for a wonderful photographic tradition.
You have class on a Sunday?
And Max has a gift.
I'm so
of course,
sorry.
As you all know, the photo portrait has been popular since the early 1800s.
This?
Your generation was not the first to use images for selfie expression. Sorry, I couldn't resist. The point remains that the portraiture has always been a vital aspect of art and photography for as long as it's been around. Now, Max, since you've captured our interest and clearly want to join the conversation, can you please tell us the name of the process that gave birth to the first self-portraits.
Weird. Oh, okay, you're talking about the game. I thought you meant you're actually in class. I did know.
I did know, but I kind of forgot.
You either know this or not, Max. Is there anybody here who knows their stuff?
Louis Daguerre was a French painter who created daguerreotypes, a process that gave portraits a sharp reflective style like a mirror. Now you're totally stuck in the retro zone. Sad face.
Very good, Victoria. The Daguerrean process brought out fine detail in people's faces, making them extremely popular from the 1800s onward. The first American daguerreotype self-portrait.
I can't believe I still have his pencil case. I should upgrade to the 21st century.
You can find out all about him.
But I like it old school.
Or even online. And guys, don't forget the deadline to submit a photo in the Everyday Heroes contest. I'll fly out with the winner to San Francisco, where you'll be feted by the art world. It's great exposure, and it can kickstart a career in photography. So Stella and Alyssa, get it together.
Mr. Taylor, Jefferson totally tells you exactly what he does in the beginning of the game.
I see you pretending
not to
see.
That's the point I wanted to make right now. And I really hope there's nobody in this chat that hasn't finished the game. Because boiler bomb. I mean, like,
Victoria doesn't
who hasn't finished
second,
the game?
Kissing ass.
Yeah, exactly. How can you not finish it? Alright, let's have some nice music. Oh god, I shouldn't do this so much. I don't want this stream to turn into just me talking about random shit the entire time. Because I do get taken, like, I do get carried away. Like, you've all seen it. Like, I get carried away. Yes. Jefferson totally admits to everything in the beginning of the game. He admits to being able to frame you in a dark corner when you're very vulnerable. He also made a very, very interesting comment right there, something about the height of innocence, and I do believe that is why Rachel Amber was murdered. they had a sexual relationship together, right? And from the four chapters that we played so far, I would definitely consider Mr. Jefferson to be sort of a sociopath. Like, he saw Rachel Amber as something, and the moment she was framed in his dark corner, she no longer had any of the attractiveness that he felt for her before. Plus, she woke up, so those are two different reasons why she had to die. Her innocence is gone, the girls go missing after he takes their photos, and she found out the truth. The exception in this game so far is Kate. But Kate almost had a suicide. I'm pretty sure the guy didn't have a chance to handle her yet. But yeah, anyway. The comment he made about being able to frame any of the students in a dark corner at their most vulnerable, he also says that any of them can do the same to him. Which is why I think that Max will take it out on him. I don't think he's going to be making it to the end of the game. I think he's going to get exactly everything that he deserves. What would be cool is if the game gave you a choice whether you wanted to do that or not. That'll be interesting. Yeah.
I just worked so hard in the shop, and I'm sure you know what it's like to be consumed by your work. I just really think Everyday Heroes is an important cultural event, and I want to represent Blackwell Academy.
You have to Rachel Amber totally loved both people. Like, something you gotta realize about that girl is she's very goal-orientated. Her goal was to get famous, become a model, get to Hollywood. And there's two or three different ways to go about that. One would be to have her shoehorned into it by a famous photographer like Jefferson. And another would be just to get there through Frank's connections. Guy had an RV, he was in love with her, he had money, he's a drug dealer. He can get her to Hollywood, no problem. So could Jefferson, no problem. Whether she loved these men? Really?
Another daily fail in front of the world.
Yeah. I wouldn't say she didn't like Chloe. I feel like her and Chloe were friends, but Chloe probably loved her more than she loved Chloe. It was definitely not an equal affection happening. Yeah. Just like how it's not an equal affection what's happening between Max and Chloe. Max has done everything she can to save Chloe's ass, but Chloe still goes about it like willy-nilly. Like, she has moments where she appreciates everything that we do, but it's not
often.
Hi, Kate.
Oh, hi, Max.
You seem quiet today.
Just thinking too much.
And I swear to fucking God, this will be one of the videos. I swear to freaking God, I think she's related to Frank.
I think Victoria has already won the contest, as usual.
She's got nothing on you, Max. Well, I should get going.
Yeah, me too. Talk to you later.
Sure. Let's talk later, Max.
Right, so, God, I'm not gonna worry about the photos, I'm not gonna worry about the notes. What I want to do is to have a completely different playthrough than what I did. So I'm just gonna be mean to everybody.
Every time I look at Victoria, I feel like she's talking smack about me. Excuse me.
Probably because she is.
Mr. Jefferson, can I talk to you for a moment?
Yes. Excuse you.
No, Victoria. Excuse us. I'd never let one of photography's future stars avoid handing in her picture.
Do I have to? I just don't think it's that big a deal.
Max. You're a better photographer than a liar. Now, I know it's a drag to hear some old dude lecture you, but life won't wait for you to play catch-up. You're young, the world is yours, blah, 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 right? But you do have a gift. You have the fever to take images, to frame the world only the way you envision it. Now, all you need is the courage to share your gift with others. And that's what separates the artist from the amateur.
Whatever, dude.
This is ridiculous. I always get so shy and nervous around Mr. Jefferson.
You didn't tell me how cute I looked yet.
I was about to. You always
welcome to the real world.
Just cute?
Hot.
Then I might send you a special picture, Jerry.
I'm not paying $150 for
because Max wants everybody to see how hip she is.
What's the point?
She plays it so
I need a serious timeout in the bathroom. Splash water on my face and make sure I don't look like a total loser.
I hate that class. It's
apologies
so
for the coughing. I have a cough. It's not super bad.
She's so fucking shy.
But it's, they're gonna come.
I've seen Brooke hanging out with Warren. She seems like his type. Girls, it's sad
too. I'll let the song play a little bit while I edit this broadcast. Oh, God. I don't understand why I can never upgrade my or update my broadcast name for some reason. It's so weird. Dashboard. Oh, fuck. Whoops. My bad. Oh, God. Okay. Whoops. I'm sorry. Oh, fuck. Whoops. My bad. Oh, God. Okay. Whoops. I'm sorry. Oh, fuck. Whoops. Okay. My bad. Disaster. I'm trying to title this broadcast real quick. I just want to label this while I have a chance. Okay, so this is the... Okay. This is the downside to... Damn, never mind. It's never gonna work. Okay.
It's just one stupid picture, not your soul. Miss Grant is a great science teacher. Place, wondering why she cries sometimes. Talking there's Juliet from my dorm. Yet another Vortex Club disciple. Figures Juliet would be dating Zachary. Jocks sucked up in the Vortex Club. God, Samuel is such a weirdo. But I kinda like that about him. That's when I fly. Sorry about that. Whenever I click away from the game window, apparently the sound just cuts out, and I forgot. I can't ever update my empty broadcast
good
title.
I don't
nobody
know
can see my meltdown, except for me.
Okay, so here, Rachel Hunter's a bitch. So here we go.
Just relax. Stop torturing yourself. You have a gift. Fuck it.
A little pet theory. I have no way to prove this. But all those pictures that Max
when
took,
the door closes,
their Polaroid
a window
camera,
opens. Or something
I feel like she
like
can
that.
Jump through them.
Okay, girl, you don't get a photo op like this every day.
Yeah. Right, so earlier when I was talking about how there's a difference between, maybe I should just show you right now. Okay, next time I get the autosave, I'll show you. There's a difference between the photo that Max just ripped up and the photo that's in the chapter select menu. And I feel if that wasn't an artistic oversight error and that was on purpose, then it's very important in that it would definitely support a little pet theory I have that all of this has been reoccurring over and over again. And as it recurs over and over again, her wall gets more and more full. But it could always just be artistic oversight. Always.
It's cool, Nathan. Don't stress. You're okay, bro. Just count to three. Don't be scared. You own this school. If I wanted, I could blow it up. You're the boss. So what do you want?
I hope you check the perimeter, as my step-ass would say. Now, let's talk business.
I got nothing for you.
Wrong. You got hella cash.
That's my family, not me.
Oh, boo-hoo, poor little rich kid. I know you've been pumping drugs and shit to kids around here. I bet your respectable family would help me out if I went to them. Man, I can see the headlines now.
Leave them out of this, bitch!
I can tell everybody Nathan Prescott is a punk ass who begs like a little girl and talks to himself!
You don't know who the fuck I am or who you're messing around with!
Where'd you get that? What are you doing? Come on, put that thing down!
Don't ever tell me what to do! I'm so sick of people trying to control me!
You are going to get in hella more trouble for this than drugs.
Nobody would ever even miss your punk ass, would they?
Get that gun away from me, psycho!
No!
Whoa. What the fuck? How can that be? I was in the bathroom. He shot that poor girl. I held up my hand. And then I was back here.
As he likely was. These pieces of time can frame us in.
I already heard this lecture.
From light to shadow. From color.
Now Kate is being hassled again. And if Victoria's phone rings, this is real.
Now,
shit.
Can you give me an example of a
Damn,
photographer
I cannot believe
who
this.
Captured the human condition in black and white?
Okay, if I'm crazy,
anybody?
I might as well go all the way.
Bueller?
Diane.
Can I actually reverse time?
There you go, Victoria. Why Arbus?
Yes, you can, girl. So, I guess during this stream, you guys will get a sneak peek into my process of like,
I did
now,
it.
Theory crafting.
I actually did it.
A photographer who perfectly captured
human
the human condition
machine.
In black and white. Anybody?
Max,
Bueller?
Don't freak out. Not yet.
There you go, Victoria. Why Arbus?
Because of her
Keep
images
it together, Max.
Faces. You feel like totally haunted by the eyes of those sad mothers
when
and
I took my selfie, Jefferson
she
asked me a question.
Tortured, right?
If he does again, I'll know this is for real.
Keep that to yourself.
Seriously, Max, though, no one cares
I could
about
frame
Max,
any one of you in a dark
why.
Corner and capture you in a moment of desperation. And any one of you could do that to me. Isn't that too easy? Too obvious? What if Arbus chose... I believe Max has taken what you kids call a selfie. A dumb word for a wonderful photographic tradition. And Max has a gift.
I know I'm not dreaming
course,
this.
You all know, the
it's real.
Portrait has been popular
I can
since
tell.
The early 1800s. Your generation.
So I can go back in time.
For selfie expression.
What if that girl isn't dead yet?
I couldn't resist. The point remains that the portraiture has always been a vital aspect of art and photography for.
I need to go to the bathroom quickly and check it out.
Now, Max, since you've captured our interest and clearly want to join the conversation, can you please tell us the name of the process that gave birth to the first self-portraits?
This is so interesting. Got a next spammer so soon. Is it the time of day? Time you out. okay. So. Oops. There we go. Okay. What was I gonna say? Oh, admit it. Everybody should admit it. Now that you know who he really is, you hate his goatee, don't you? David was right.
I'm sorry, but I really have to use the bathroom.
Nice try, Max. But you're not gonna get away that easy. We can talk more after class. Is there anybody
oh,
here
shit.
Who knows their stuff?
Jefferson wants to keep me after class. Was a French painter. And I need time to save that girl.
A process that gave portraits a sharp reflective style like a mirror. Now you're totally stuck in the retro zone. Sad face.
Very good, Victoria.
What if I rewind
the
again
Bagarian process
and give him the right answer?
Fine detail in people's face.
So, basically, what I do when I play the game the first time is take a mental note of everything that I think might be important. I do my edits, and when I do my edits, I write down notes. I write down ideas about connections, about the possibility of their like deeper meanings and stuff, and that's why I have stacks and stacks of paper like on my desk for the past, how long has it been, like 8 months. And when I find an idea that makes sense, that I could support with evidence, or sometimes the evidence is just there, I see it and then it all just comes together.
Well, Max, since you've captured our interest and clearly want to join the conversation, can you please tell us the name of the process that gave birth to the first self-portraits?
It's the Daguerrean process.
The Daguerrean process, invented by a French painter named Louis Daguerre around 1830.
Somebody has been reading as well as posing. Nice work, Max. The Daguerrean process made portraiture hugely popular. Mainly because it gave the subjects clear, defined features. You can learn more when you actually finish reading the assigned chapters. Max is so far way ahead of Evan. And guys, don't forget the deadline to submit a photo in the Everyday Heroes contest. I'll fly out with the winner to San Francisco, where you'll be feted by the art world. It's great exposure, and it can kickstart a career in photography. So Stella and Alyssa, get it together. Taylor, don't hide. I'm still waiting for your entry, too. And yes, Max, I see you pretending not to see me.
Max, so like, you are not crazy. You are not dreaming. It's time to be an everyday hero.
See? There's more there's so much foreshadowing in the first episode if you go back and really look at it. And the first time I played this, I came in assuming that this game would just be like a fun thing. It'll be like a little fun adventure game. And then it
Why
became
is this
something
happening?
Much more.
And to
and
me.
Thank goodness that I need to edit the episodes that I put out, right? Thank goodness for that, because during the edits are when I started noticing thematic things that could be happening.
Nice answer, Max. Are you okay? You look pale.
Kate, did we talk at all today?
This is the first time. What's wrong?
I'm sorry, I'm just dripping. Too much stress.
I know the feeling.
Now you poor girl.
I wish we didn't. I do have to go, but we can talk later if you want.
I'll see how I feel. Thanks, Max.
I'll be nice to Kate. I'll be mean to everybody else, including Warren. Alright. So, I have a habit of overthinking things during my playthrough because I get way too into it and I get lost in my thoughts and I just ramble. And there's no. I feel like it'd be a butchering if I cut out every single time I think I said something stupid, which I do say a lot of stupid shit. So if you watch the playthrough, there's a lot of rambling, right? and a lot of overthinking. This could be something that's I'm just overthinking too. The beginning of the game, we start out with a tornado. Every single time Max dives deeper into her powers, she sees a tornado after, like in the junkyard, etc., etc. Could just be a stylistic
thing.
This
is so fucking bizarro.
Be an intro to the game, but if you want to keep up with the rest, like keep the motif of the tornado with according like in line with the rest of the game, should have come after Chloe got shot. So I wonder, it just makes me think that this is a recurring thing, you know?
Victoria hasn't moved from that spot.
Alright.
Excuse me, Mr. Jefferson, can I talk to you for a moment?
Yes, excuse you.
No, Victoria.
No, I'm not gonna be mean today.
Excuse us. I'd never She's let cool. one of photography's future stars avoid...
I'm
fuck not avoiding,
you.
Just...
Biding time? Waiting for the elusive right moment?
Exactly.
Max, don't wait too long. John Lennon once said that life is what happens while you're busy making other plans. Go on now. Don't let me stop you.
Okay. I will take off then. Oh god, okay, I hate- Oh god, it's making me. Oh, lame. Forgot about these things. This is the first time I've played the game again. Like, I've been avoiding doing second playthroughs on my own for fun because I don't want my decisions getting mixed up. This will be the first time I've started a second
Excuse
run.
Excuse me.
What?
I really hope this doesn't affect me for- I don't think it will. It's just early shit.
I'm on top of it. I think John Lennon once said that life is what happens while you're busy making other plans.
Max, you're on fire today. All the right answers, good. Make sure you finish working on it by today. I have faith in you.
Victoria's black shirt? Totally could be. I mean, yeah, totally could be. But then again, black is a very common color. I was really iffy about adding black to that theory, just because black is just a common color. But you definitely knew that she was gonna get into trouble. Just look at this interaction, you know? Well, something else I don't remember if I said this or not, but during the first time I was playing this game, I didn't think anything of it, and then during the editing, I was getting really, really suspicious about how Jefferson kind of like plays favorites with Max. She does not deserve any kind of favoritism at all. So I thought that was
really
creepy.
I hope I have enough time to get to the bathroom. Please. I can't tell anybody. They'll think I'm crazy.
Because Max wants everybody to see how hip she is. As if.
Shut up!
She's so shocked.
They have no idea what's going on with me, and I can't tell them anything. Stop staring and go.
Mostly white, mostly blue. Black and gray. Boys are safe. Her, Dana.
God, I wish I could talk to somebody about this. But how can everybody look so calm when I feel so stressed?
I know you didn't forget you owe us cash.
I forgot for what?
Daniel is getting bullied all over again. I hope he doesn't. Daniel is getting bullied all over again. I hope he doesn't remember.
Not the boss, bro.
No, I'm just trying to go to class.
Grand Prix.
Oh, frick.
Brooke has no idea of the shit going on right now.
Max, calm yourself, girl. It's okay. Shit, dude. It's okay.
You know I don't tease.
I hate that science class with those
Nobody here can help you. Move.
Okay. You're like a ghost to these kids.
Okay, Max. Retrace every step. I washed my face. I shredded my photo. Then the butterfly flew in, and I took a photo.
Hey, spammer.
Leave them out of this, bitch!
I can tell everybody Nathan Prescott is a punk ass who begs like a little girl and talks to himself!
You don't know who the fuck I am or who you're messing around with!
Where'd you get that? What are you doing? Come on, put that thing down!
Tell me what to do.
Wowzer, it's happening again.
People trying.
No, he has a gun. I should do something else.
Than drugs.
Nobody.
Max, you're going to get hurt.
Miss your punk ass, would they?
Get that gun away from me, psycho!
I'm too scared to get near this. Holy shit, I can't let this happen. No. If I can. No, he has a gun. I should do something else.
Oh, shit! No! No! Shit! No! No! Don't ever tell me what to do! I'm so sick of people trying to control me!
You are going to get in hella more trouble for this than drugs!
Nobody would ever even miss your punk ass, would they?
Get that gun away from me, psycho!
Oh, shit! No!
That stupid fucking kid.
Shit!
You don't put your...
I need to rewind and do something fast!
Don't put your finger on the trigger unless you want to kill somebody. And
don't
then Chloe
ever
pushed his
tell
hand.
Me what to do. I'm so sick of people trying to.
I need a hammer to break it open.
You're going to get in hella more trouble for this than drugs.
Nobody would ever even miss your punk ass, would they?
Get that gun away from me, psycho!
Nobody would ever even miss your punk ass, would they? No way!
Don't ever touch me again, freak!
She kneed him in the groin. I don't know how he...
Another shitty
not,
day.
Like, still on the floor. Ow.
That did not happen. This cannot be real. I just saw a girl get shot and then saved her. What the fuck is going on? Do not freak out.
Yeah.
Hey, do you hear that fire alarm? That means you should be outside.
I had to use the bathroom.
Girls always use that excuse.
Excuse for what?
For whatever you're up to. Your face is covered in guilt.
The alarm tripped me out.
Then trip on out of here, Missy. Or are you hiding something? Huh?
Thank you, Mr. Madsen. The situation is under control. There's no emergency here. Leave Miss Caulfield alone and please turn off that alarm since that's your job.
How did Nathan hear the breaking glass and kill Max? Never noticed that before. I would say it's because he's not a cold-blooded killer. I think that bullet was an accident. I honestly do. His finger was on the trigger. She pushed the gun off of him. The push back triggered his reflexes, so he pulled it. Like an idiot. You're not supposed to have your finger on the trigger unless you actually want to kill somebody. That's like rule number one. Yeah. He does confront her later, regardless of what she tells the principal. Yeah. Also, okay, I'll talk about it in the parking lot. This guy. This guy's definitely in on something super suspicious. However, I wouldn't categorize him in the same kind of evil that I would put Jefferson in and Sean Prescott in. I think... Oh, quick question for everybody in chat, if you want to participate. Who do you think the two most important characters are? Not your favorite characters, the two most important characters in this game. But yeah, I wouldn't be surprised if by the end, Wells does something good. Like, he admits to being part of something bad, or he helps stop this whole conspiracy, because I think they have him in his pocket.
You look a little stressed out. Are you okay?
I'm just a little worried about my future.
You're sweating pinballs. Is that all you're thinking about? You can always be upfront with me, Max. Or have you done something wrong? Is that it? Well, Max, talk to me.
Nope.
I just got sick in class. Female trouble.
Except you're wandering around like a zombie. And do you think that's the first time a student has used that line on me?
It's the truth. I felt dizzy in Mr. Jefferson's class.
Just tell me what you're hiding. You can trust me.
There's nothing to hide. I got sick. It happens, you know.
There's that teen toot again. You know, I've heard enough. Don't think I don't know what goes on around here. You've only been here for 3 weeks, and you're already causing conflict. I don't think your parents will approve when they find out. Now get outside with class. Please.
Man, fuck you, dude. Like, this shit.
No, he does not buy that at all. I may have just flushed my scholarship down the toilet.
Whatever, Max.
Yes, I could rewind and actually tell him the truth.
This first episode brings back a lot of, like, angsty memories. Max and Chloe, Nathan and David. The two most important characters are Nathan and Chloe's dad. So, I think the most important character in this game is Max, and the second most important character is Nathan. Because of the way the game uses him. The guy's completely misunderstood, and they use him as a plot device. Just look at the way the entire game, up until episode 4 too, is pushing him to be the bad guy, the bad guy, the bad guy. But at the end of episode 4, when you find out what happened to Rachel Amber, there's one photo of him where he's on the ground with her. He's drugged. Max assumed that he was a sicko and like posed with her body, but I don't think so. I think he was in love with her, and that knowing that she was gonna be a victim, he couldn't handle it, so Jefferson had to drug him too, and he was the sick fuck that took her photo. Yeah. I read somewhere that there's a theory going around that, like, it's actually not Rachel that's buried, it's Nathan. Because of the blue... When Chloe digs up Rachel a little bit and, you know, has that... And she smells that awful rotting person corpse smell. There's a blue thing, right? I thought it was a trash bag at first, but then I realized... I think that's Nathan's blue jacket. In the alternate timeline... You see Nathan in a blue jacket. My thoughts? You see Nathan in this timeline with a red jacket, but this is after Rachel has gone missing. I feel like Jefferson took Nathan's blue jacket, wrapped Rachel's body up in it, put it in the ground, and buried her in that shallow grave. Nathan doesn't have a blue jacket anymore, so he goes and buys a red one. His entire perspective on life goes upside down. He has a psychotic breakdown. He was in love with Rachel Amber, and now she's gone missing, and he could be a cause for her disappearance. I would have a mental breakdown if I were him, too.
Rachel Amber. She looks so hopeful and pretty.
Nathan is so important. Like, see, the way I look at this game, as a 5-episode mystery. It's the mystery of what happened to Rachel Amber, the mystery of what's happened to Kate, sure. But the real mystery is what the fuck is going on with this tornado and Max's time rewind powers. Everything in this game is super realistic except for a time rewind power. That, I don't understand yet. That is the biggest mystery. And who's at the center of that mystery? Maxine. What would be the best tool to trick the audience with? Maxine. Just pay attention during this playthrough and look at her comments through this way. Like, don't listen to her. Listen to how she says things. She says things into your head. She injects her thoughts straight into your brain, so you kind of go with it, right? But she doesn't know the truth. You gotta remember that. She doesn't know the truth. She knows as little as we do. But she has assumptions about everybody all the time. Yeah. Nathan definitely has a lot of anxiety throughout this entire story. But remember, this story starts on Monday. Rachel has already gone missing. We have no idea. Like, the player has no idea who these characters are, what they're like before Monday, right? And it's just so convenient that Max is a social recluse and an outcast. So she doesn't really know her classmates that well either. So Max learns about them as we learn about them. That's one way that the game injects us into Max's brain and injects Max into our brain. We kind of become one with her. We side with her, we empathize with her, we want to take care of her, and we see everything through her point of view. However, that is the biggest, easiest way to mislead the player into thinking exactly what you want. The reason why you do that? The payoff. The payoff at the end of 8 months. Episode 5, so many people are gonna get swept under the rug. I swear to God, nobody's gonna see shit coming.
Okay, I better get to my dorm and grab that flash drive.
I see two ways this game could end. I honestly think that this is all a dream. The reason why it's a tornado, why there could be a ton of disaster. I guess a tornado coming towards Arcadia Bay makes sense, especially since the Pacific Ocean's right there. But a tornado's cyclic, right? Just like time paradoxes. I feel like Max and Chloe could have been doing this thing over and over again where Chloe's meant to be dead. She's meant to die. Yet Max keeps jumping back into the tornado of time to try to figure out a new way to do it. And every single time, like, time just goes on. There's gotta be a reason why there's this, like, 500-year-old homeless woman
what is going
behind
on
the diner. And the ways I think this game will end, the way I would want this game to end is with a choice. Whether Max lets Chloe die for the third and final time, letting her best friend die to save the town, or sacrificing the entire town to jump back into the spiral of time to do it all over again. You start right back from episode 1. You start right back in the dream with no information, just like how we started episode 1. We started episode 1 with nothing. We go through the entire 5 days. We might jump back in and do it all over again. Would you do it all over again for your best friend? Would you just say, fuck you, Arcadia Bay and everybody in it. I'm going to try to save my best. I'm going to keep doing this forever until I figure out the right way to do it. It's kind of tragic, right?
Come on, Logan. Bring it, bro.
On that note, oh, see, like, this is what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
I could. The only thing stopping me from making like a lot of like fast theory videos is that I really believe in quality, so I try to make it as artistic as I can. I try to make my theory videos not only do they make sense, but they're presented well. And the shortest theory video I've ever made was like at least 12 hours from start to finish. That's why I have stacks of papers. Like, it's all in my head. They're all in my head, but I just don't have time between like all my other obligations. No. Are also read some theories that Max is actually dead and the times with Chloe's are just memories.
I
had that
on,
too. Yeah, or she isn't even real. Yeah. Yeah. That's the other possibility that like this could all be a dream and Max is just living a recurring dream, because at the beginning, when the top of that lighthouse is falling down on her, everything fades out to black and she wakes up in the classroom, right? So from Monday till Friday could all be a dream.
Yeah.
And the storm is her limbo. The reason why she would be in limbo is that she needs to realize that it's all a dream and she needs to accept her fate. Or could be the different kind of recurring dream where she needs to go back in time and save her best friend over and over again. That could totally be a limbo too. Purgatory or a hell. Oh, thank you so much for saying that, Sphinxy. That means a lot to me, like, really.
Dude.
Like, compliments on my work are always the best. Thank you.
Nice.
Yeah. I believe either of those. If Max was already dead and is just living a dream.
Hi, Kate.
Hey, Max.
When I was finished with episode 4, I felt strongly about both of those. But lately, I've been leaning towards the wanting to choose between saving the town and saving Kate. But then again, both can apply, because she could still make the choice about whether she wants to save her best friend or wants to save everybody, but it could all be a dream and it's all pointless.
How did you like class today?
I don't remember. I guess I don't care about much of anything today.
Is there anything...
Max, I'd like to be alone, if you don't mind. I'm sorry.
Oh, we're gonna be a total bitch to Victoria. Oh my goodness. Sup, nice, Sammy? Bro.
Howdy, Samuel.
Well, hello there.
I totally pegged you the wrong way, man.
You look busy, Samuel.
I'm always up to something. Today it's sweeping, then painting windows.
Just don't paint over the posters for Rachel Amber.
You can't color over that sunlight.
You know, to be honest, I barely remember the theory videos I make. I make them, and I put them out there, and I just let them go. Could have been me, could have been somebody else. Could have been me in my head, intending to make the idea, but never doing it. I have no idea.
You knew Rachel?
How can you know a prism? You just stare in awe. Now I have to go paint windows.
All the choices for nothing, I would say. Oh yeah, are you the murderer? Nice. Yeah, I totally had this guy pegged the wrong way. I loved him after starting episode 2. Like, it's just like, wow, the way he talks. I feel kind of bad about myself at that one. But the choices are not for nothing. They're really not for nothing, right? Because what is this game? This game is an experience. This game is here to challenge the way you think about things. By the end, when the truth is revealed, if you really take the time to think about it and go back and mentally see all the things you chose to do, thinking that there was a goal at the end, that's value in and of itself. If, let's say, if, hypothetically, if by the end, it's just an arbitrary choice. Let Chloe die, or let the town die, jump back, do it all over again, it's all a dream, nothing matters, blah blah blah. You know at the end nothing matters, but up until that point, everything mattered to you. Kate suiciding, Chloe's mental breakdown, Chloe in the wheelchair asking for assisted suicide, all those things mattered at that very point. Nice. All the motifs in this game, frames, paintings, or photographs, you know, like, every single moment in life matters. That's what I get out of this. Like, and what better age to deliver that message than the cusp of adulthood, when everybody's, like, all these children are turning 18, they're becoming adults. Like, every moment you have matters.
What was she like? She must have been popular.
Even sunlight can cast shadows. Rachel did both at once, you know. She was like a battery, positive and negative.
It's like playing a good book. That's what this game is. It's like playing a good book. Yeah.
What do you think happened to her?
Best not to dwell on the past. Samuel looks forward, like a clock.
See you later, Samuel.
And watch your step around here, Max. After I sweep, I paint.
Something else that I find fascinating, absolutely fascinating about Max's character is how incredibly relatable she is to a lot of people, including myself, which is one reason I feel so strongly about getting her out there and helping her become the beautiful butterfly that I think she is inside. Easy for me to do to help. Extremely hard for me to do if I were her, right? Doesn't that tell you a bit about how humans are? We want the best for other people, but we can't have that best for ourselves. It's just, it's weird. People are weird.
Oh look, it's Max Caulfield, the selfie hoe of Blackwell.
Bitch.
What a lame gimmick. Even Mark, Mr. Jefferson, falls for your wave hipster bullshit. The Daguerrean process, sir. Awesome. You could barely even say that. I guess you got your meds filled.
You know what Since
you
funniest.
Know all the answers, I guess you have to find another way into the dorm. We ain't moving. Oh, wait. Hold that pose. So original. Don't worry, Max. I'll put a vintage filter on it right before I post it all over social medias. Now, why don't you go fuck your selfie?
Oh, yes, Victoria. I'll get your bony ass out of my way.
So, I never said this. I never talked about this. But one of the funniest things about Victoria for me is I actually had a roommate named Victoria who had pretty much, like, a very similar haircut. Very similar bitchy attitude, but she was cool.
Yeah.
It's just so weird to see this. It's just so weird. Gotta go further. Oh, never mind. Should make fun of her.
Nice.
What the hell? Are you kidding? Look at this.
Chill, Victoria. It's just water.
Yeah, water on my cashmere. Do you know how much this fucking outfit costs?
You look great.
I can't even chill on the steps.
Oops, I do believe it was the paint first. Yeah. There we go. I don't know, it feels kind of weird playing it a second time. It's like I'm living a double life, you know?
Sweet.
It's like every single time you play a different playthrough, it's another attempt at the wheel, or at the... spiral of fate.
I don't want to mess with that ladder and hurt poor Samuel.
No, you understand.
I just want to get Victoria the hell out of the way.
Keep walking, hippie. Okay. I forgot to do something.
I could crank the sprinkler up and give Victoria and her clones incentive to beat it.
Yes. Well, I know it was the paint can, but I forgot what I had to do. I know Sam wasn't supposed to be looking. There it is.
Sorry, no paparazzi allowed.
Oh my god, I remember having this much trouble the first time too. Turn off the sprinkler, she's just gonna walk away. Guys, do any of you remember? It's been so long.
I don't want to mess with that ladder and hurt poor Samuel. I just want to get Victoria the hell out of the way.
Keep walking, hippie. Sorry. No paparazzi allowed.
Oh, yeah, that's right. It makes you watch it every... Ah, okay. That's why. Thank you. Yeah, you're supposed to get an option to interfere with the paint can, but you don't get to until Sam does his work. It's little bits like this that are, like... Pretty negative things about the game. There it is. Ugh, okay.
Nice.
And yep, there it is.
Okay, let's see if this works.
And now we wait. Too bad there's not a fast forward button. I'm gonna let Alyssa get hit by every single thing that comes up. What time is it over here? Right now it's 3:14 p.m. Pacific
what the
time.
Hell? Are you kidding? Look at this!
Chill, Victoria. It's just water.
Yeah, water on my cashmere. Do you know how much this fucking outfit costs?
You look great.
I can't even chill on the steps.
Victoria?
Oh, Samuel is sorry. Wet paint is not good for hair, nope. Sorry.
Get the hell away from me, weirdo.
That's so sad.
Hold on. We'll get some towels. We'll be right back.
So move your ass before I drive.
It worked. Don't mess with Max, bitches.
Just after midnight. That means you are on the Eastern Hemisphere. Yeah. Seriously, though, like, if I had the time to, I could do several video essays all about how, like, this game is an example of interactive art and storytelling.
What are you reading?
Love today or die forever. Don't even say anything.
No.
It's a bestseller. What to say?
Good point. Now if you'll excuse me.
Righty.
Yeah.
Be mean to her? Uncomfortably?
Hey, Victoria.
What do you want, Max? Don't.
Stupid.
Don't say a word, Max.
Oh, wait. Hold that pose.
Oh, dude.
And no filter needed before I post this. Now, please move. I've had a messed up day and I'm going to my room.
You do that? I know where you live. So does Nathan.
Maybe I shouldn't have done that. Now I have to get to my room, then see Warren.
That look, yo, like, that look is the game does a really good job with, like, facial emotions when it counts. You can tell when it counts. You can tell when it doesn't count. I mean, Max has a zombie look, like, nearly the entire game, but when it counts, you know. Ooh, so this is Stella's room. Red rum, right?
Victoria is going to be pissed we took so long.
Red rum right here is a, is murder backwards. I think it's a reference to The Shining, right? So there's another theory that Stella is involved in the kidnappings, the conspiracy, the murder of Rachel Amber. She said so herself that she heard it from a good source that Rachel Amber slept with Mr. Jefferson. Who is a better source than Mr. Jefferson or Rachel Amber herself? Mm-hmm. Right? It's actually quite possible that Stella is very much involved in this conspiracy as Jefferson's assistant, and Alyssa...
Just get to your room and grab Warren's flash drive.
To a lesser extent. This is reaching. I'm going to admit this right now. This is reaching. This is reaching pretty far. But there's evidence that Stella, Alyssa, and Kate were really close friends before what happened to her at the Vortex party. After what happened to her at the Vortex party, Stella and Alyssa are now estranged from Kate. Stella shows not really any kind of emotion towards Kate. She's totally indifferent, and they used to hang out. Alyssa sort of cares, but she doesn't directly comfort Kate. Makes me wonder, if they were like really close, genuine friends, why not be there for your friend? Conspiracy? Maybe. I hate to think that everybody's out to get Kate, though. So... totally dream. Just gonna go totally dream.
After all this action, how sad. I didn't write anything. I have nothing to say.
This is the saddest motherfucking thing I've seen in a game in a long time. Hello, Sisiput, Southern Hemisphere. Where are you from? Down under? Hey, Wallflowers.
Home sweet home. My favorite cocoon.
Alright. I think we have a chance right now. So, you see how... Okay, let's go through this then. You see how full... Oh, New Zealand. Cool. So, you see how full this wall is, right? Let's... Never mind, I was wrong. Take that all back. Fuck, my bad. Must have been seeing things. Huh. Yeah, definitely seeing things. Whoops. And that's my elimination process to know when I don't have evidence. Yeah, I don't know. I've never really had like this much interaction with people like from all around the world. This is pretty.
How sad. I didn't write anything. I have nothing to say.
And now streaming has been pretty interesting and pretty rewarding. Big Theory crumbles down. Yeah, it happens. This is the first time anybody's ever seen it, but it happens. There's been a lot of theories that are like admittedly pretty out there in crackpot, but the moment I find even a shred of like even a shred of evidence that would crumble something, I don't make a video. Even if it's done, I go through it, I watch it several times, make sure everything's like on point. If it's not on point, it goes to the bin. I don't release it. But the one caveat right there is that I go with every single piece of evidence I can get from the game itself. I don't go in the game files. Somebody did call me out on the one I did about the voices. Jefferson, like, loading up the syringe
just
with the drug.
Just get to your room and grab Warren's flash drive.
I claimed that the voice wasn't Max, it was Kate, I think. But somebody had gone into the game files and found the subtitle files, and it actually is Max. So I'm wrong there, but we'll see. I don't know. I really don't know. I didn't go into the game files. Notice me, senpai, already? Hey, Neko-ga. I turned the face cam on because you said so.
Home sweet home. My favorite cocoon.
Yeah. I don't know. That's a funny thing about theories. You never really know. It only takes one piece of evidence from somebody that's just a little sharper than you to throw it all down. But hey, put your shit out there. It's whatever. It's all good. I do it because I love this game. Oh, water it today, not water it tomorrow. We can keep Lisa alive. We can keep Lisa alive.
You are thirsty. I'm the worst.
Oh God.
Ever. Drink up.
Yeah, I also think going to the game files for a theory is a bit too much, too. I think it takes away the fun, you know? Like, I do theories for fun. Like, I wouldn't be getting all in-depth with this game. I wouldn't be making theories. I wouldn't be doing as much as I do for Life is Strange if I didn't find it extremely fun. Yeah, Lisa's gonna live. How's the stream going? It's going pretty good. It's been an hour and a half, and I'm barely, like, not even halfway through episode one. It's gonna be so slow.
One day I'll organize my film collection. One day I'll get an actual HDTV.
So, for those of you who stick around to the end of this, I don't know when this is gonna end, but if you stick around to the end of this, or if you want, you can comment on YouTube later. If you're interested in continuing this Shits and Giggles playthrough after episode 5 comes out, let me know. If everybody's just done with Life is Strange after episode 5, I can just stream other games. It's all good. Right, let's grab that flash drive.
Looks like Dana left me a little great. Now I have to go get the flash drive from Dana's room.
can't get out now, Dana. So tell me the truth or rot in there.
Welcome to real drama queens of Blackwell.
I'll try to do a long stream, but I am kind of tired.
Hey, Juliet, is everything cool?
Oh yes, Max. I've locked Dana in the room because we're cool.
So, here's the tricky thing with all the stuff that I've been doing, like wedding, family, camping, started dwindling on time to make theory videos. There's at least two, probably three actually, three would be a better number. Three videos I really, really want to get out, just so I can say I got them out, in case I end up right. But I only have one day. Literally after this stream is over, I need to start working on those. I need to edit some Soma, and then I need to work on those theories immediately, because I only have a day. It's only one day left before episode 20 comes out. Yeah. As long as you keep streaming good and theory-worthy games. Yeah, I think so. We'll see. I mean...
She's your friend.
Friends don't sex with their best friend's boyfriend.
No, probably not. How did you find out?
Why do you care? Why are you even asking me? You never talk. Just zone out with your camera.
That's why I'm talking to you now.
What's my last name?
Juliet... Watson.
Juliet Watson. Duh.
I'm flattered. I didn't even think you knew my name at all.
Of course I do. Just because I don't talk a lot doesn't mean I don't care. So, how did you find out about them?
According to Victoria, Dana would do anything to date a quarterback.
According to Victoria? Huh.
She saw the sext, and Zachary won't answer his phone. Once Dana admits it, she can go. Straight to hell.
Max, I swear so cold. I didn't do anything.
All right.
But I bet Victoria did. I know the proof is in her room.
All right, Sphinxy. All right. You failed to save Kate the first time you played, right? It was pretty devastating, right? It really hurt, right? If you continue the playthrough, push through to the end, and found out in episode 5 that it's all a dream, how would you feel about how much you cared about Kate's death? If you can just jump back into the time spiral and do it all over again, how would you feel?
I can help Dana and check out Victoria's room to find out if she is the kind of person I hope she's not.
Like, just the way the game starts, it's like you go through episodes 1-5, you finish episode 5, you don't like the ending you got, you say, fuck it, I'm gonna start all over again from episode 1. I'd be so, so incredibly impressed if Don't Nod had maybe not a ton of endings, but like a few multiple endings that are really determinant on early game decisions. Like really early game decisions. Like decisions like how well you treated Nathan, how well you treated
Alyssa. I need to get to Victoria's room now.
That's probably not as important as people think. Right? So Sphinxy, you would feel better knowing that you can just jump back in time to save Kate again, right? But does that decrease the meaning behind how much you felt for Kate the first time? It just devalues it, right? That's what I'm saying. If everything was a spiral, at the very least, it would make certain, like, it would make a number of people really ponder the way they look at things. Like, a life is precious until you realize you can go back and redo it.
Oh man, this is so wrong. I better find proof fast.
Like, when I play games, I'm naturally, like, really, really nosy because I want to know everything. But Max is a nosy person too. So we go back and we fuck with people. We learn about people without them knowing. We snoop, we pry, because we know we can just go back and redo our mistakes, right? Right. So what is life then, you know? Fuck, it's too much to think about sometimes.
That's boom. This is the email I need to show Juliet. Now I have to print this fast and get the hell out of here.
Oh, print it. Oh shit, how do I print it? There it is. I don't know if it's the same spam bot. I don't really care. Like, it's not that bad. It's not like the chat's moving incredibly fast.
Thank you.
Oh, wait, hold up. I never got to do this the first time. I had to go back and do this when I was taking the extra photos.
Let's play a little photo Tetris and leave Victoria a message. Let's move this here and this one there. A pattern is emerging.
Stupid. Yeah, I don't know. Sometimes I feel like I go too far, so I try to hold back, and then I wonder, you know, this is just me. Why not just let it out there? I mean, I feel like the people who came to watch the stream, they knew they were, you know, you all knew what you were kind of getting yourselves into, even though I didn't really say much about it. So I'm okay with going a little bit too far.
Remember, you're not a criminal.
Too weird.
You're a ninja, so move.
I don't know.
I'm not letting her out until she tells the truth. Leave me alone, Max. Get a clue.
Oh shit, did I forget the print? Okay. I forgot the paper? Yeah, it has been a while.
This better convince Juliet that Dana is innocent.
Oh, I don't really care about taking the photos because this is just a for fun playthrough. I want the consequences, I don't need the photos because I've already taken them all. Yeah, that's also why I'm not doing a lot of like in-depth exploring because the first time I've scoured everything.
Juliet,
or
read
almost
this.
Everything. I'm also going by the assumption that everybody here
has
already played it themselves.
I'm an asshole. I'm sorry, Dana.
You are. And I hope so. You really think I'd mess around with Zachary?
No, but I get stupid jealous. I owe you dinner. Still love me?
And you do my laundry.
Thanks, Max. You're like the Blackwell Ninja. Now let's see what Zach has to say about Victoria.
You set me free. Thank you. Warren's flash drive is on my desk.
Yo, Juliet. You know, those two be banging, you know?
Almost done. Get the flash drive and then I'll go see Warren. Up.
That these emos show up in the game.
Hey, Dana.
Video?
Seriously, thanks again. I can't believe Juliet locked me in my own room. Real mature.
Poor Juliet gets her rage on. I hope she doesn't kill Victoria.
Zachary should worry too. As if I'd let that ego case jockstrap touch me. But I bet Victoria would be all over that action. Or has been. Max, you're smart to be a loner here. Though Warren obviously likes hanging with you.
Oh, and then I don't know. I feel like games like this are just so, like, to me this is barely a game. Like, all I do is run around and examine stuff. It's like an interactive book. So I don't know how you can be really bad at it. No offense. Another poll. Who do you think's a bigger asshole? Logan or Zach?
What do you mean?
Oh, nothing. When you opened the flash drive, didn't you see the special folder called Max?
Yeah, okay. I gotcha.
Are you blushing? Go ahead and grab the flash drive whenever.
Blushing for Warren? Fuck yeah, girl. Of course I am, dude. He's cute as fuck, dude. Come on. Oh, I'm not even gonna take this one back. Somebody's
Max,
pregnant.
That's mine. Thank you. You're not helpful. You're just nosy. I think you better go.
Okay. Okay, this is gonna
nice,
be awkward
Max.
As fuck.
You hurt her
fuck.
Feelings by being so damn nosy again.
No,
Max.
Not
but I
gonna
could
take
rewind
back.
And make it up to her.
I said,
sorry, Dana.
Please go.
Sorry, girl. I'm gonna piss you off.
Dense.
I'll piss everybody off.
Go.
Great.
Yes, I am.
I'm Dana even more stressed.
There's
Are
no
you
more
okay?
gossip for you here, Max. So go.
Fuck.
Great. I made Dana even more stressed.
Let's go all the way.
There's no more gossip for you here, Max. So go.
Yo, like, the, char- characters can just turn on you like on a dime. Like the conversation we had with her, like I think it was like episode 3 or something. Just turn on a dime. It's crazy. Okay, let's get out of here. Nobody's gonna like Max by the end of this.
No need to go there now.
Oh. Oh wait, the flash drive, duh, stupid. Like, I know what to do, I assume I already
go.
Do it.
You are dense. Go. Max.
Oh.
Enough.
Oh yeah, Max will be the biggest shit after this playthrough.
Must protect my precious so Max never has to chase it down again.
Nice, Max. You hurt her feelings by being so damn nosy again.
There's no more
gossip
for you.
But I could rewind and make it up to her.
Right. Well, let's go. Now it's time to be a dick to Warren. I think Logan. I personally think Zach is a bigger douchebag.
Ow! That hurt!
Damn! I better rewind.
Nah, she's fine. Are you crying? Oh! Walk away! Hey, you're such an asshole.
Get lost, hipster. I'm not doing any interviews.
Yeah, those are the reasons why I think he's a bigger douchebag. Hi, whore. Hope you enjoyed the pick. It's your last one. Oh, boy. I'm so excited. Oh, this is gonna be bad, too.
So don't think I'm blind. I see everything here at Blackwell. Do you understand what I'm saying?
No, and leave me alone.
It's gonna be hard to be a bitch to both David and Chloe, because it's always you have to side with one or the other. I wish I could be a bitch to both of them.
You can't fool me. I know everything about this school. I cover the waterfront, so you better figure out what side you're on.
Please, leave me alone.
We're gonna destroy the family, though. Oh, on that note, so...
Hope you enjoyed the show. Thanks for nothing, Max.
I did enjoy it. Don't jump off the roof.
Man, I should have stepped in between Kate and David. That asshole was so over the line. I could rewind and try something different.
Nope. High school years. Doesn't this game just take you back to high school though? Holy shit. Green bracelet, what does that mean? I really don't know. I really don't. She's an outlier. That's what it means, I guess. So something really, really important, I think I should just pause it to get this out there right now. Something really, really important, right? The question, the big question, or not the big question, but a big question would be, who's gonna save Max? Who's gonna bail her ass out, right? It's my guess how she, oh God, should I get into this now or later? Now or later? Let's get into this now. I'm sorry about the pausing, just wanna get this out. Chloe has 3 bullets. The first one was 3 bullets around Chloe's neck on her necklace. The first one was Nathan's bullet in her to her gut. The second one's Jefferson, right? The final time Chloe will die would be by the hands of Max. That means she's not dead yet. That means Max is gonna turn back time using a photograph. Most likely the selfie that Warren took of himself and Max, right? That's how Warren will play a part of this. Who's gonna save her though would be David Madsen, and David Madsen is most likely gonna be notified that they're in trouble because of Nathan. Remember, David Madsen has a relationship with Nathan. Nathan follows David Madsen. David Madsen tells him who to follow.
Man, I should have done something. That guy was an asshole.
The reason why I think those two have a relationship is twofold. One, Nathan was trying to protect Rachel from getting involved with Jefferson and potentially becoming his next victim. And two, David Madsen wanted to bust Rachel Amber because she was a bad influence on Chloe. What better way to protect your girlfriend, or not, maybe not girlfriend, what better way to protect the girl that you like, the girl that you love, from trouble than getting her ass expelled from the school where all the dangers are? The easiest way to do that would be to manipulate the overprotective and over-paranoid security guard who hates her guts. Easy. That's the relationship those two have, and that's why I think that Nathan would have David's phone number.
How could Zach and Victoria do that to me?
Why even bring this up? For some people destroyed...
I have to go find Warren and give him back his flash drive.
They tore apart the Price Madsen home, right? Some people sided with Chloe, which resulted in David packing up and leaving, right? So if he left, why would he come back? One, he would come back for the rest of the stuff that wasn't in his suitcase, or two, he'd come back because somebody called him, said they were in trouble, and Chloe left the laptop open with the GPS coordinates. It's just a sensible thing that would happen, in my opinion.
Hi, Juliet. How are you doing?
Oh, hey, Max. Sorry, I'm still screwed up.
I won't bother you then.
Bother
I don't care.
Then. I have to go see Warren before he melts. See you.
Yeah, I'm sure we'll all be partying later with Zach and Victoria and the Vortex Club.
Yeah. Sure.
See you around, Max.
Neko guy, you're still in high school? Get Master Zanget. Get all your girlfriends expelled. That way, they don't have anything to do but hang out with
Rachel
you.
At least Rachel Amber has people who care about her.
I'm not a role model. Just need you guys to
now
understand
this really
that.
Pisses
I'm not a role
off.
Model.
So entitled. Sorry, handicapped folks. My truck needs these two spots more than you do. Bastard.
Soon she'll need two wheels. The irony is amazing.
It's not a dirty window unless somebody writes clean me on it.
Your flow of speech gets interrupted by Max all the time. I could not do this so good. Like, hey, get used to it. You really do. I'm just so in sync with her.
That dog looks Pompadour. Peaceful asleep, but if I get too close, Kiuchow.
Right, so Warren's about to get his ass kicked, right? But before he does, Nathan is gonna put his hands around Max's neck and kind of choke her. She's gonna claw his face, right? He's gonna get 3 marks across his face. And those marks kind of heal over the next 3 episodes. If you go through the game again and, like, just go through it all again, you'll realize every single time we see Nathan after episode 1, his scar on the side of his face gets more and more healed as the days progress. That's crazy amounts of detail, correct? Why even bring this up? It's because the details in this game matter. Sometimes I feel like I'm crazy and I'm overthinking things and I'm looking too far into things and the evidence is there, but it was unintentional. But why the fuck would they put that amount of detail into something so small as a scratch across the face for the next three, four episodes if the details didn't matter
in
this game?
Come on over here, please.
That's really desperate.
What up, Max? How are you?
Here's your flash. Thanks.
No problem. Check out my new wheels.
Cool. Very old school.
1978 to be exact. Now we can go to the drive-in. There's one in Newburgh just 60 miles away.
You're in the wrong time, Warren. But then, so am I.
You okay?
It's been one strange fucking day.
Man, I saw that Victoria didn't take down that pic of you on Facebook. Major bitch move.
Someone just called me their husband. Are we at that level now, chat?
I don't want to talk about it.
Jeez, you're a little miss sensitive today.
I wouldn't push your luck, Warren. Not in the mood today.
So, did you get a chance to check out the movie booty on my flash drive?
I've been busy, boy.
No, I've been way too busy with class and life.
Damn, girl, you had it like a year.
Or a week. I did browse through all the titles, drama queen.
Ha ha. Make sure you watch Cannibal Holocaust.
Nah.
No fucking way will I watch that. My mind is twisted enough.
I laughed my ass off.
So you're sensitive.
Ouch, that sounds awful the way you say it.
Not at all.
Sensitive is good, unless you're a pushover. You have hip taste and a quick mind.
Thanks for noticing, Max.
The right girl will too.
If I was lucky. Speaking of hip and fast, we should cruise out in my car to an actual movie this week. But you seem distracted.
Nah.
I don't want to speak about it. This is kind of a crazy day for me. I mean, I literally think I'm going crazy.
I may be a pest, but I'm a good listener.
For reals, Warren, this is between you and me, not social media.
Don't insult me. Max, go on.
I had this incredibly bizarro experience in Mr. Jefferson's class today. I mean, life-changing. Have you ever had a dream so real it was like a movie?
Max Caulfield, right? You're one of the Jefferson's photo groupies?
I'm one of his students.
What the fuck ever? I know you like to take pictures, especially when you're hiding out in the bathrooms. You best tell me what you saw, now. Answer me!
What are you talking about?
I know you're new here, but don't even play stupid with me.
I'm not new. I've lived here for years.
Then you should know the Prescotts own this shithole.
Then you don't have to worry about me. Worry about yourself.
Do not analyze me! I pay people for that. Worry about yourself, Max Caulfield.
This is like an amped up situation. You guys are talking about wedding cake.
Take a step back, Nathan Prescott.
Oh man, you're telling me what to do?
Get away from her, dude!
Ooh.
Hey! Leave him alone!
Nobody tells me what to do! Not my parents, not the principal,
that!
Or that whore right in the bathroom!
Right there.
Max? Chloe?
No way. You again.
Brian, hold on. Bro, I got this.
Ow.
Hey, Max.
So now you know how
get your punk asses.
You know how Nathan said that
don't
he pays people to psychoanalyze him? Guess who that is?
Man, Nathan Prescott is messed up and dangerous. This day never ends.
Oh, and thanks, Chloe. After 5 years, you're still Max Caulfield.
God, I can't stop thinking about Ashley Birch whenever she opens her mouth.
Don't give me the guilty face. At least pretend you're glad to see me.
I am seriously glad to see you. Oh, and thanks, Chloe. It makes perfect sense I'd see you today.
Yes, it's been that kind of day. So what did that freak want with you?
Yeah, exactly. There's a reason why Nathan's a bad person. Like, that's why I think he's such an important character. He starts off completely in the negative. Like, there's no reason to give him any benefit of the doubt because he treats our baby, Max, so poorly. Like, the dude motherfucker choked him, shot our best friend. Like, there's no reason to like him at all. And even now, a lot of people say, like, okay, I guess there's a reason why he's fucked up and crazy, but I still don't like him. I still think he's a bad person. But I think there's going to be even more uncovered. Like, if it turns out that I'm sort of right about the whole Rachel Amber situation and how he was trying to get her kicked out to protect her, that might make him a little less bad, you know? He does bad things, but he doesn't mean to. It's a sign of... I don't know. At that point, do you blame people who are crazy for being crazy? Like, can you do that? Is that PC? I don't know. I really don't. I don't think about that. So, he's a good character. He really is.
I have no idea. I know he's a Prescott.
And an asshole. Your friend really stood up for you.
Warren,
Yeah, I owe him big time.
You're not the only one in debt, and you're already causing trouble.
I thought it would be quiet here. Feels so weird to be back.
So I guess Seattle sucked hard?
Nah, that's fucking awesome. It's away from you.
No, it felt like a real city for artists. Big and bright. Great for taking pictures.
Yeah, must be hard coming back to a hick town like Arcadia again.
Not after seeing you.
Please, girl. You came back for Blackwell Academy.
Only for Mark Jefferson.
Only for Mark Jefferson. He was a pretty famous photographer in the 90s. I've always loved his work.
Those that can't do, teach. I'm glad you found a good reason to come back.
Don't you think I'm happy to see you?
No. You were happy to wait 5 years without a call or even a text.
Yo, give me a break.
Give me a break. I was going through changes. Like you.
I guess those changes included dumping me from your life.
That's not true, Chloe.
Bullshit. You thought you hook up with all these art pricks in Seattle. Didn't happen, though.
You're merciless.
You've been at Blackwell for almost a month without letting me know. Enough said.
I just wanted to settle in first and not be such a shy, cliche geek. I totally would have contacted you.
I bet you don't use these sad excuses on Mr. Jefferson. Don't use them on me, Max.
Sometimes I feel like a bad person because the more I dive into these characters, the more outwardly I seem to hate them. Like, I don't hate them. I love these girls. I love these characters.
Broken.
That's one reason I care so much to dive too deep into them.
Not everything changes. Except my camera has officially taken a shit.
My step douche has a boatload of tools. Maybe you can fix it in my place.
I need very specific, tiny tools.
Bird alert. My stepdad has a fully stocked garage, and he actually is a tiny tool. Welcome home, Max.
Like, there was a conversation I had through the comments section that really actually made me think. There's a viewer that was accusing me of, like, not giving Chloe as much attention or benefit of the doubt as I've been giving Nathan. And that person was kind of right. It made me realize, like, if I go back and watch myself talk, you can kind of get that feeling from me, but it's not what I actually feel inside. It's
come
just,
on in.
I really
don't
love this girl, but she frustrates the fuck
nice.
Out of me.
Nice. Home shit.
It's
home.
Like in the beginning, it was like I wasn't that close to her, so I was a lot nicer to her. But now that I feel like we are fucking besties, I'm just gonna be fucking harsh because she's a little shit that needs to get her life together. I say that because I care.
My room looks a bit different than the last time you saw it.
It's cool. At least we can chill out.
This isn't exactly my chill-out zone. My step-fuhrer makes sure of that. Come in and close the door.
Do I usually rewatch my playthrough?
Put on some music while
no,
I medicate.
I don't rewatch my... I don't watch my stuff after I post them. I record, and then I edit. And I edit very closely to remove any imperfections. Like... poor mouth lip syncing. It takes a lot of time. Sometimes I remove coughs, I remove sneezes, I remove like sometimes weird lip smacks, like so, because it happens. So I remove those like sharp sounds.
When's the last time I had to dig through Chloe's crap?
It probably seems like I don't edit at all, but I edit a lot. I just choose to edit in a way that makes it seem like it's very minimal. But after I post it, I don't go back to it unless somebody's referring to something specific in the comments section and we're actually getting into a discussion. And then that's when I go back and like watch bits and pieces.
So tell me, what does Max Caulfield do for fun now that she's a grown-up?
Not much.
Not much. You know me. I like to observe the world more than participate.
I can't say I know you anymore. Maybe you love to go clubbing every night.
Can you see me at a rave?
I'd dose those candy-flipping morons and watch them twitch into a DJ dance death rattle. Take a photo of that.
Yeah. So, totally right, Sphinxy. It is much more important. I think it's much more important to have characters with flaws because flaws give people depth. Flaws are what connects. Flaws are what help a viewer, a reader, a player identify with people. Everybody's got their own problems. That's why even though look at what this game really is. It's a fucking Snoop simulator. Like, we're just walking around looking at shit. Literally, this is the game mechanic. Click. Look.
We had such a blast drawing these together.
Listen. And rewind. The only thing this game has going for it is storyline and character. And why are the characters so good? It's because they're all fucked up, just like people. Everybody's a little fucked up. Everybody lies. No exceptions.
Hey, that TV used to be in the living room.
Snoop Dogg simulator? Yo, Rachel Amber was trying to get to, like, what? Long Beach? Or was it Laguna Beach? Somewhere in Southern California.
She looks super happy. She looks super sad.
She looks super happy. She looks super sad. She Holy looks shit.
Super stoned.
I don't remember this. How did I miss this? This is amazing. Oh god, Chloe. This girl. I could be friends with this girl. She's a fucking mess, but I could be friends with her.
Who'd have thunk Chloe wouldn't pay her parking tickets? She does love trouble.
So if I hide in the closet, she's gonna pin the blame on me. If I have a chance to, I'm just gonna put it back on her. I'm so red right now. Oh yeah, it's okay. It's really hot in my room. It is mid-October. Still hot as balls down here. So once in a while, I just get a little flushed, especially when I get way too into it and say something that I think is embarrassing. I try to keep composed, but inside I'm like, fuck, why'd I say that? That's fucking stupid. What am I doing? And I get all flushed, just like earlier.
You won't play without any power.
Like, seriously, I wonder sometimes why I do face cam. Like, seriously, like, it takes... Oh my god, I really wish I didn't have to do face cam. But it's gonna be up there on the internet. I'm already on the internet. Fuck.
Now, let's see what kind of music Chloe is into these days.
Skullberry must be nice. Must be nice. Yeah. It's a little sweaty. I wonder if I can just take a moment.
Hey, give me that!
Sorry.
Rachel Amber always looks
different. Obviously, she's
different.
A good friend.
Every photo I see of her, I don't get it. I understand their photos, but damn. Zanky, you're such a troll. Yeah, Hakuna Matata, man. Hakuna Matata.
That's Rachel Amber. Her missing person posters are all over Blackwell.
Yeah, I put them up. She was my angel. After my dad died and you moved, I felt abandoned. Rachel saved my life.
Man, I had no idea.
Well, you never made much effort to find out. I was 14. We were best friends.
Rachel took my place, that bitch.
So, Rachel took my place. I'm glad she was there for you.
Rachel had my back. We were gonna kick the world's ass. You would laugh at how different we were. She wanted to be a star.
She looks like a model.
That was her plan. Our plan. Get the hell out of Bigfootville and into Los Angeles.
Yo, like, sometimes when I stream, it feels like a raid. I sit here for, like... Well, last time I sat here for, like, 7 hours straight, no breaks. What about your mom?
What about your mom? What did Joyce think about all this?
She couldn't wait to get rehitched. Step dick is one reason I wanted to bail.
I feel the love. Now, when did Rachel actually disappear?
6 months ago. She just left Arcadia. Without a word. Without me.
How do you know? What about her parents? I forgot what I asked last time.
How do you know she disappeared? Maybe she wanted to start a totally new life.
Unlike you, she would have told me, okay? Something happened to her.
I believe you. I'm just trying to get all deductive.
Before Rachel left, she said she met somebody who changed her life. And poof.
And you haven't heard anything from her since?
Like everybody in my life. My dad, you, and Rachel. Gone. Can you put on some music now?
Better hit that joint pretty hard, girl.
Anyway, you can find tools to fix your camera in the garage.
Chloe, are you okay?
Sure, I'm awesome. I just want to blaze and be alone for a moment.
I wonder if it's safe for me to get out of the... Yes, it is safe for me to get out of the window for a second and then just ban these guys. I was timing these spammers out, hoping that they would quit, but they're not real people. Are they? They're not real.
15 kids in the backyard drinking wine.
But I think that cut the music out for like a second, right?
You tell me stories of the sea. And the ones you left behind.
Goodbye. Bye, Miss Aka. Nice having you here.
Seen this place in 5 years. Seems like forever. Brr. I can feel autumn pushing out to summer. What do you truly want to do when you grow up?
Max, I'm already grown up. What about you?
Travel. That would be awesome. Explore the world, go far from here.
Far from me? Thanks a lot, dude.
Dude, you have friends here in Nekoka. I need a bodyguard for our adventures.
I would be like Lara Croft, except real. That would be majorly cool.
Totally. We'd have cars and boats and planes all over for instant escape. And no adults could tell us what to do.
Count me in. What would you do while I was bodyguarding you?
Maybe take pictures of our adventures. I would love to be a photographer. As if I ever could be.
What are you talking about? Max, you are a photographer. Your pictures could be in a museum. Someday they will. I believe in you.
Something I've learned over the course of my life, something you can take away from this game too. It's really up to you, but it might not be the amount of friends you have or the number of people you know. It's all about the quality of those people. You don't need a lot. The little you have should be good though. Wallflower, that's a moment where you tell the DM to shut the fuck up or you're gonna come after him. No one takes your weapon away.
Nope.
You have your husband.
Nope. Someone locked it from the other side.
Oops. I hope I didn't make y'all deaf.
I should be able to find the tools I need deaf. Here.
With that laugh. Whoops. Okay. Come on.
Boom. Precision screwdrivers. Except I can't reach them.
Can I just slip the cardboard down? No, I have to fail first. Great. Okay.
That was very smart, dumbass. No can reach.
Yeah, if you just let me take over for you, Max, you wouldn't be such a dumbass. God, fuck. You'd be more of a dumbass. But you'd be doing great dumbass things. Just let me take over your body. Just let me take over your body. Hey, ladies.
Yes.
What's the first thing you'd do if you could take over a guy's body? Like, what? Like, seriously, legit, what is the first thing you would do?
I should go back upstairs before Chloe freaks.
Oh, answering machine.
Chloe, if you're listening, Pete was cruising home off duty and told me he saw you near that garbage dump. Now I've ordered... told you to stay away from that place. It's dangerous. And you got no idea what kind of scum are living out there. Stay away. I'm serious.
You don't think I want to know? people are weird. I know the first thing you do though. You'd like pull out your pants and take a little peek. How do I know? Because that's what I would do. First thing I do.
You found the tools. Sweet. You can sit at my desk and fix your camera.
In a momento, I'm gonna wipe the shine off my face.
So?
I can't fix this thing.
Are these your new photos?
Yeah. I just took them today.
Let me see. Nice framing, too. Are you shitting me? That asshole's everywhere.
That's right, Fufoku. A large freak.
No way. When did you take
you
this?
You know.
You took this photo, you brat? In the bathroom today. You set off the alarm. That's why Nathan raged after you. It totally makes sense. You hella saved my life.
That's right.
Now tell me the truth, Max.
I wasn't there. You're delusional.
I wasn't there. Come on, even after 5 years, I can still tell when you're lying.
Okay, I was there, Sherlock.
That is so badass.
Oh yeah, I almost wet myself when I saw the gun.
So, did you recognize me?
No.
Not at all. Your hair and clothes are so different.
I hope so.
What if it's not large?
I'm sure this is all so weird to you after coming back.
Well, just
like
having
said,
it would be cool.
It's been that kind of day.
So you must have overheard our conversation.
I would try being the pitcher instead of the cat. Hey, you can play ball by yourself too. Super easy. I don't even know what she asked me.
Just a bit.
There's no way you didn't hear every single vowel.
Okay, I only heard something about money, drugs, but that's it.
Now for the big question. Did you tell anybody?
So, sometimes in this game, you can literally play this with one hand.
No, I didn't know what to do.
Like, sometimes I literally just play with one hand.
That's some intense shit.
Maybe I should go to the principal.
The principal? Are you still 12? That drunk jackass only cares about cash for Blackwell Academy. Don't trust him.
Seriously, I didn't blab to anybody. Promise.
Thank God. I'll tell you more someday. And I seriously owe you, Max. I didn't know it was your birthday last month. This was my real father's camera. I want you to have it.
That's so cool you remembered my birthday. But I can't take this.
Of course you can. My dad would be pissed if I never used it, and now I know it'll be used awesomely. And I'll snag this picture as a symbol of our reunion. Cool?
Third arm?
Yes, of
course
it's cool.
More like third leg.
Thank you. This camera is so sweet.
Now that we got that mushy shit out of the way, I feel like stage diving. Let's thrash this place.
You're crazy.
This is like,
insane in the brain. Let's dance.
The most awkward part of this episode.
Or take my picture with your new camera.
Really, really weird. Like, do people really do this? It's kind of weird.
Song fucking rules. Can't dance, hippie? Come on. Rock out, girl. Yes, break it down, Max.
Yo, turn it off. Turn it off.
How many times have I told you to stop blasting that punk shit?
Dude, the music's not even on. Asshole.
I'm coming up. We need to talk.
Oh, no fucking way. You need to hide now. My stepdad will kill me if he finds you here.
Chloe, what's going on? Open this door, please.
Chill, I'm changing. Is that okay? Max, find a place to hide now.
Chloe.
Do cut it. I'm gonna fuck this up this time.
Chloe, you're stalling.
I'm changing. Give me a minute.
Get smart. Just let me in. Now. Please.
Do I want
Chloe,
the snow
I'm
globe?
Coming.
Yeah, I want the snow globe.
Chloe, you're stalling.
Oh, never
I'm
mind.
I'm changing. Give me a minute.
Move this.
Don't get smart. Just let me in. Now. Please.
1 second.
Can't pull the snow globe anymore.
I'm not screwing around, soldier. Chloe, open this door.
Shit.
What's going on in here?
Jesus, I'm just trying on clothes. Right. You're so friggin' paranoid.
Yeah, combat will do that to you.
You guys are funny.
One of my guns is missing. Did you take it?
Oh, God, I didn't take your stupid gun. You do know I believe in gun control?
Wait, is that grass? You been toking up again in here?
Oh, yeah, guns, weed. You were tripping balls.
I'm sick of your disrespect. Tell me the truth. That's an order. Whose is it?
It's Chloe's.
Stop treating me and my mom like we're your family platoon.
Hey, leave Joyce out of this.
I wish you'd leave Joyce, like now.
Oh! Damn, fuck.
Chloe, I'm sorry. I care about your mother and you just keep pushing me.
By the way, I have proof you got all up in Kate Marsh's face today. Surveillance proof.
What? You best stay out of my work.
Then stay out of my life.
Chloe? Someday you'll grow up.
Oh, thanks.
Hey, you okay?
Welcome to the real stuff douches of Arcadia Bay.
I'm sorry.
For what? He would have been a bigger dick if he caught you in here.
That's hard to believe.
Anyway, let's sneak out the window. There is one cool place we can go to in this hick hole.
David was such a mean bastard to Chloe. What if I had stepped up to help?
I'm very happy that y'all feel comfortable enough in this chat to come out of your lurking holes. I understand. I am a lurker too. First time on Twitch? Awesome. This is my second time on Twitch. Oh, I don't even know what I'm doing. God.
As far as I know, if I use my power, it might help.
As far as I know, it's all terrible. But so David. David's fucking just David. I feel like he was trying to get Rachel kicked out of school because he wanted Chloe to like shape up and fly right. But after she went missing, he probably saw Chloe's downward spiral into depression and started wanting to help her out by finding her friend. So sad.
Damn, what are you waiting for? Open the window!
Why don't you open? It's your room, man. Why don't you open the window? God! Yeah, Twitch virgins. I got my Twitch virginity taken away from me by a bunch of people. Telling me not to fuck it up. Don't Twitch, Chow. Don't Twitch. Oh shit! We're almost done with episode one. Holy crap!
I haven't been here in forever, so why do I feel like I was just here? Whoa, this is the exact same path I was on during my nightmare today.
Okie doke. Let's see, another episode.
I feel like I'm
what,
in my nightmare.
Another 2.5
again.
Hours? So, five. Another 2.5 hours would be 7 p.m. here. A lot of you are, like, in Europe. So, it will be, like, getting into the a.m. morning. How are you guys awake? Good luck.
Birds are so lucky, they can always escape.
It's a nice haiku.
A tree haiku?
Turn this way now.
How pretty. A tree
haiku?
Turn
this way now or face a little orange tree. And never look back. Turn this way now. Take a look at the lonely autumn tree and never look back. Lonely autumn tree. I want to say it's not important, but it might be, but it probably isn't. Come on, you're overthinking it, man. Oh shit, I never knew. Never noticed seagulls in this game.
You sure you don't want to be alone?
Sit down if you want.
Pissed?
Are you pissed at me?
I just wanted some backup.
I'm not as brave as you. And David is indeed a step douche.
I'm sorry you had to experience it firsthand.
You have to live with him. Has he always been this way?
Ever since my desperate mom dragged his ass to our home, I never trusted David.
Felt weird taking his photo.
I felt weird taking his photo with Kate, but he was such a bully.
Yes, he is. But why was he bullying Kate? She's kind of boring.
He has some kind of weird agenda.
He has a lot of secret files. Rambo still thinks he's gathering enemy intelligence. Did you take a peek?
Where are you from, Sessaput? It's Monday, 12 p.m. Whoa.
I wish. You know I would have read them.
I'd love to. They must be important, or he wouldn't hide them deep in his garage bunker.
He kinda creeps me out. I bet the truth is out there in his files.
Most likely, but it's good you didn't find his files. He would go ballistic. He's a total surveillance fetish. Where are there spy cams in the house?
Sometimes ignorance is bliss.
No wonder I'm so miserable. Everybody in this town knows everybody's secrets.
Even yours?
Even yours?
Not anymore.
So what do you have on Nathan?
He's an elite asshole who sells bad shit cut with laxative. And he dosed me with some drug in his room.
What?
I met him in some shithole bar that didn't card me. He was too rich for the place and too wasted, and he kept flashing bills.
Just tell me what happened, Chloe. Now.
I was an idiot. I thought he was so blazed it would be an easy score.
You needed money that bad?
Actually, yes. I owe big time. And I thought I'd have enough for me and Rachel if she showed up.
I already know how much, so what about Nathan?
So, what about you and Nathan?
We went to his room at Blackwell. We drank, and I laughed at his rich kid bullshit. He was one step ahead and put something in my beer.
God, Chloe, I can't believe this. I mean, I do. Then what?
I know I passed out on the floor. I woke up and that perv was smiling, crawling towards me with a camera.
Go on.
Everything was a blur. I tried to kick him in the balls and broke a leg. Nathan freaked, so I managed to bum rush the door and get the hell out. Max, it was insane.
Oh my god. That's so fucked up, girl.
That is so fucked up. What did you do then?
I figured I would make him pay me to keep quiet. So we met in the bathroom.
And he brought a gun.
That was Nathan's last mistake.
He's still dangerous, Chloe. Not just to you.
Good thing you didn't tell anyone. Nathan Prescott better watch his back now.
I won't always be there to save you.
You were here today, Max. You saved me. I'm still tripping on that. Seeing you after all these years feels like...
destiny.
If this is destiny, I hope we can find Rachel. I miss her, Max.
I miss her too.
This shit pit has taken away everyone I've ever loved. I'd like to drop a bomb on Arcadia Bay and turn it to fucking glass.
Rachel! Rachel! Rachel, come back! Rachel!
Is Chloe still up there? I have to find out.
Rachel! Oh wait, it's over here. That's silly me. There we go. Okay. Before I approach the end, interesting thing about Rachel. Everything we know about Rachel has been hearsay from other people.
I've never seen a storm like this in Oregon.
Neither you, the player, or Max has met Rachel in person. All we know about Rachel is from what other people's accounts of Rachel were. So, I keep that in mind. That's why I don't really know much about Rachel. I like Rachel based on the fact that she affects Chloe so much. But it's hard to really gauge.
I feel like the dough is eating me.
Gauge.
Oh my lord! The tornado
my opinion
is back.
Of her.
Is this for real?
And it seems like she's trying to help Max out. Oh no, it's happening again! There we go. Wait. Inside this... Is it just me? Or does it kind of look like a birdcage?
October 11th? Is this Friday? That's only 4 days away!
So, okay.
The tornado is headed straight for the town.
Sometime after the second episode, I did the calculations,
Chloe,
and I was thinking to myself,
I'm back.
It'd be so motherfucking badass if episode 5 came out
on
October 11th, the last day.
I didn't black out.
It would've been so great.
I had a vision. The town is going to get wiped out by a tornado. Oregon gets about 5 tornadoes every 20 years, which is so. No, I saw it. I could actually feel the electricity in the air. Come on, take a breath, okay? Chloe, I'm not crazy. But there's something else I have to tell you. Something hardcore. Talk to me, Max. I had this same vision earlier in class. When I came out of it, I discovered I could reverse time. Like I said, not crazy.
But I, right?
Listen to me. How do you think I saved you in the bathroom?
By reversing time? Yeah, sure.
I saw you get shot, Chloe. Saw you actually die. I was able to go back and hit the fire alarm.
Okay, I see you're a geek now with a great imagination, but this isn't anime or a video game. People don't have those powers, Max.
I don't know what I have, but I have it. And I'm scared shitless.
You need to get high. It's been a hell insane fucking day. What the hell is this?
Snowflakes?
It's like 80 degrees. How?
Climate change. Or a storm is coming.
Yeah,
Max,
I like every song in this game too.
Start from the beginning.
Music
tell me everything.
Or so, it got me worried about Rachel's voice now. I imagine her having like a deeper, slightly gruff, very sultry voice. So, I'd be very disappointed if she sounds anything. If she sounds like anything but Freddie Mercury, like she better sound like Freddie Mercury. Tyra? I forgot that one. Susie, Lynn, Kelly, Rachel.
Okay. Been through the credits once already. I think that's okay. This is gonna be an amazingly, amazingly rude playthrough. Let's make sure we pick the least favorite choice. Oh fuck, I didn't blame Chloe! God damn it, I wanted to blame Chloe. I forgot how to blame Chloe. Okay. Well, everything else is like the minority choice. Didn't let Daniel draw my portrait, didn't sign Miss Grant's petition, didn't help Alyssa, didn't erase Kate Slade. I watered my plant though. I touched Dana's pregnancy test. Alright. Now let the bird die. Oh, fuck that bird. Let's see, didn't break Chloe's snow globe. Dang. Right. Something I'm pretty sure I forgot to mention. A note on the surveillance, right? During my first playthrough, during the Let's Play, I was so against the whole surveillance thing. But then after a while, I thought about it. I tried to make this theory before episode 4, but I failed. But the nature of surveillance in and of itself isn't bad. Surveillance isn't inherently bad. It's just that knowing that David Mattson was the chief of security and thinking he's kind of sketch and he wants to add like a bunch of security cameras made me think that he's up to no good. Later on, when we find out that he actually might be trying to do good, the security cameras, the surveillance cameras, don't seem that bad at all. Hell, it might have been there to protect the students, like he said. So it's all about perceptions, right? Also, if you interact with Miss Grant, you get biases from Miss Grant and from Max. And that's why I was just all like, yeah, sure, I'll sign it, whatever. I like these two people. Just, ugh. Yeah. Alright. You guys want to keep going? Or do you want to just call it a day? I know a lot of people should be working on, like, their projects. Let me know if you want to keep going. I'm pretty sure I have enough in me for one more episode, for sure. Yeah, I can go either way too. Yeah, especially, like, it's a Sunday too. Like, here, even on the West Coast, it's about to be like 4:30. I don't want anybody to, like, I don't expect anybody to, like, spend the rest of their weekend, like, here on Twitch with me. You know what? Okay, we'll call it a day today. If, you guys are interested in having, like, this continue, let me know in the comment section on YouTube if you get around to it. And, whatever. It's all good. When would we continue? Probably right after episode 5. So, me, how I usually operate is, it'll come out on Tuesday, right? And then I'll download it, I'll play it. I usually take like a day or two, no more than three, to finish playing through the game. Like, I blocked out everything so I can finish this game. Once that's done, we can continue this whole for funsies playthrough. Twenty-four hour stream. Okay, you know what? I'll keep going then. If there's enough people that want to keep going. What I'm going to do is I'm going to take a quick break so that I can cut this video right here on episode 2 and then just have this uploaded, and then the next part will just be... Alright, cut this episode 1 and then upload immediately, and then we can just like continue on. So, 5-minute break. I'll be back in 5.